Hello there, doll lovers. Let's get this Diana Prince out of the box, shall we? Alright. So, when the Wonder Woman movie came out, and all the dolls hit the shelves, there was just so much to choose from. It was a little overwhelming. I decided I wanted to wait, because it just seemed like everyone left and right was getting a doll, but I wanted to be smart about what I wanted because I didn't want to get so many of pretty much the same thing. There were a few versions of Wonder Woman where she was dressed in her Amazonian clothing, and then there were several of her in her classic Wonder Woman outfit, but with like a different accessories, like a horse, shield, sword, bow and arrow kind of thing. So I didn't want to get too many of the same one, especially since after seeing several reviews, you could tell that the sword was different with different dolls. And so I guess that meant that she had more than one sword for that part of the movie. This doll has now been marked down to $350 at Walmart, and if you're lucky, you'll be able to find one for that price. Everyone has done their review on Princess Diana, or not Princess Diana, I mean Diana Prince slash, you know, Wonder Woman. This is actually my first Wonder Woman doll. I kind of waited a little bit too long, I guess you could say. I do want to still get a few of the other ones, but like I said, I want to be smart about it. I don't want to get too many of the same one. Alright, so. She can hold the sword, although, again, I kind of got to wiggle it in there. There we go. The sword hilt has two dragon heads, and then there is like some ancient lettering hieroglyphics on the sword itself. I'm not exactly sure what her hair is supposed to be up. It kind of has a very Princess Leia-like look. No buns. But it's been kind of smushed into the box, and it's gelled like crazy. It's rock hard. It's not going anywhere. Now, the way her dress is styled, there's a little slip here for the sword, which goes right behind the Velcro piece. But it kind of just looks better without it, because her back is so arched that the sword would obviously stick out. But it looks very nice. It's very Greco-Roman, beautiful blue color, and she wears her very, very high, over-the-knee, armored gladiator boots, and she's got a little plastic tie to keep her legs together, to keep it from falling apart. But while she's in this dress, she does not have much leg mobility. See, that does not get you very far. So, she probably would need to wear something else if she's going to be kicking some butt. And she's not wearing underwear. Now she's got knee articulation, elbow articulation, shoulder rotation, and head mobility. No wrist play, no ankle play. And these boots are just freaking huge. And they're split in the back to be able to remove them. And she has a larger foot than Barbie. But I have a Disney Descendants doll here. I want to compare. Let's see if Lonnie can wear them. Oh wow. That actually looks kind of cool. Especially with how short her dress is. And it still protects the knee when the knee is bent. I have been thinking about getting some of those WWE wrestling divas, which are action dolls, because they have action figure-like bodies, but they come with hair and clothing. And I think that they have the same type of body, so hopefully we can test that theory out when I finally get one, or, you know, if someone else has, they can confirm whether or not they have the same type of body and they wear the same shoes. But either way, for $350, this was a hell of a deal, hell of a steal, and I love it. And finally, I got me a Wonder Woman doll and a nice dress and an awesome sword. Alright, we're also going to go ahead and open up this fashion pack. And it seemed like when this one was out, it was quite popular. Everybody was getting it. And everyone was trying it on left and right on their dolls. And it looked really cool. I just was more focused on some of the other ones I'd missed out on. And I still haven't gotten those red pants with the leopard print on them. Those were the ones I really wanted to get. Alright. So we got black boots, purple sunglasses, neon green purse, and a cute little outfit. We're gonna pause. Alright, so here we have Diana wearing the mini dress, the purple shades, and holding on to this unique style and color of purse. It's a lime green. The purple shades are very vibrant purple. And of course this number 59 is very prominent throughout Barbie clothes. If you notice that the soccer player always has the number 59 on it. The curvy made to move dancer has the number 59 on her jersey. So I'm beginning to sense a theme that Barbie loves the number 59. And of course the shoes don't fit, so we're just gonna see. She looks really great. This hand, because it's spread out, was a little difficult to get into a certain sleeve, but as long as the sleeve is wide, she'll be able to put it on. Let's go ahead and try her on the other outfit. Alright, so this one, the shirt fits her pretty well, but the skirt does not, because she's got a bit more of a junk in the trunk, juicy booty. So you can kind of see where it won't line up. This material that the skirt is made out of is very stiff, starchy, and it does not have any give whatsoever, no stretch. But the shirt, meshy, cottony, gives a little bit. So she's able to wear that. And because it's sleeveless, it went on to her pretty well. This cute little princess dress, I want to try, see if maybe that'll fit on her. This is, like I said, I think a High School Musical doll, although I don't know. I never watched the High School Musicals. I was not interested because I kind of got burned out on just the songs when I was working at Claire's. I kept hearing that on repeat when we had our music disc we had to play, and it was killing me. Alright, so, Miss Muscular Princess. A little bit. As long as you're not looking at the back. Or she moves her arms. The lighting in here makes it look more green, but this actually has kind of an aquamarine blue to it. So, she's pretty awesome. You just gotta be able to find what fits and what doesn't, but she's able to work with. The shoes, though, that's the only thing, and I've seen some people test out different kind of doll shoes, so when you have this style of a body, you just gotta take what you can get. But she is pretty cool, and of course if I feel like it, I can rebody her, put her on a different style of Barbie body. Who knows, you know, maybe even this one. All right, So, thank you for watching this review on my Wonder Woman Diana Prince doll and the fashion pack. Stay tuned, there's more!